very pleased that we've got such a great turnout. If I didn't get to introduce myself when you walked in, my name is Andrea Holley, and I live over on Topsail Street, and I've been on the island almost 8 years now. We moved from Galveston, Texas, so got a husband and two little bitty kids. And I am the president and founder of Aquarius Kids Park, Incorporated, a nonprofit that myself and my neighbors formed to adopt the park, Aquarius Park, from the city of Corpus Christi. It's the sole purpose of the park foundation. And our mission really is to improve, maintain, and add structures to the park so that it can be a space that can be enjoyed and appreciated by the community. Okay, so that's the mission of that. So we've been working around 3 years to get the park adopted from the city. Started out when my son was 1 year old, and we would go to the park, and I was appalled by the condition of it. And I went to the POA, and I said, surely there's something that we can do about Aquarius Park. And they said, well, we're not going to do anything about it. We don't have any involvement in it. But if you want to do something, you need to talk to the city. And so I got in touch with the city parks folks, and 2.5 years later, I got a call that said, Ms. Holley, does your foundation want to renew the adoption that you have with the park? And I said, well, we were never told that we had it. Oh, well, it's signed off by the city council. Okay, well, great. So, and that's how things kind of go. You know, as you guys are probably well aware, when you're trying to do things, maybe with any government, but particularly it seems to be here. And so that was in May, just 2017. And from there, we move forward with Darren Gurley is my main contact with the Parks Department. And he is new as of around February, anyways. He's new to Corpus Christi. I think he was in Port Lavaca first. But anyhow, he's been very responsive to doing things with the parks in Corpus and working with the adopted parks folks. So we submitted to him a proposed master plan for improvements at the park. And that is over there, the picture, it's rudimentary, hello, I mean, we're a nonprofit, and that's, you know, my good drawing skills there. But that is what has been approved by the Parks Department at this time for us to move forward. And so the first things that kind of from a priorities perspective that we're doing was to repair the current equipment, playground equipment that was there to make it reasonably safe for children to play on. So we have installed the structure, the platform that was rotted out. Some of the bars have been removed and the boards have been put up because the long-term goal with that playground is to raise money to put in a new playground. Okay, so we actually have a really great gentleman by the name of Joe Solis that owns ABC Painting and Drywall that has offered to come down and paint the current structure that is there to freshen it up a little bit, maybe some splinters wouldn't be so bad, things like that. Okay, so that was our first order of priority. Our second order of priority was to get community gardens installed and work with the city on installing irrigation connections so that we could actually have a garden there to have water to water with. And they did that actually the Tuesday before Harvey did. They finished the irrigation. So there are actually 6 separate connections at the park where we could do quick connects to water the garden. They have approved a total of 4 20 plot gardens. We only have irrigation for one right now, so that's where we're starting with, is one community garden with 20 individual 12 by 16 plots in it. We need to at least have 10 of those plots paid for, sold, however you want to see it, in order for us to move forward with breaking ground on the garden. We currently have 4, so we're about 6 away from being able to kind of, you know, pull out some, you know, I guess what is the word that I'm looking for, scrape sticker burrs off, lay down weed barrier, put down mulch, build some boxes, and put a small fence around it. Okay. So we also have some approvals for some shade structures. That's a walking path. And we also have approval to put in a parking area because I do realize too that as things start to grow and the park starts to get used, that we will have some parking, you know, issues because there's not a lot of parking, just except for right there on the street, which isn't a lot. So I did mention that we are a nonprofit, and so we are not funded at all by the POA. The city is working with us minimally from the standpoint of they will install the irrigation, they will be paying for the water that we use at the park, whether it's for the community garden or to water plants, things like that, right? So they'll be doing that. They have also offered, like when we go to do the walking path, that they can source crushed granite at their cost, and they can truck it out and things like that for us without a cost to us. Obviously, the nonprofit would have to pay the city's cost for the crushed granite, whatever they get, but they would come and they would truck it and things like that, which it's really expensive, right, when you're starting to look at those things. They're going to continue to mow the park. They will continue to pull trash at the park. You know, the big mesquite tree, if you notice, had a big break in it after Hurricane Harvey. They came out and cut that up. We've had great neighbors that have come through and helped clean up some of the other areas in the park and cut some of the foliage and stuff that is there. So it truly is a volunteer effort to keep this park up and to make it look nice. Like I said, we're really interested in raising money for the playground, being kind of our first order, and then obviously continuing on with the community garden. A little bit of information on the community garden. The plots, individual plots, are a $350 one-time cost. So if you're interested in a plot, you would pay $350 one time. That essentially allows us to, the whole cost of one of the full gardens, weed barrier, topsoil, wood, because we are going to do boxes not as tall as the one at Downton. They're going to be half that height, so they're easier to access. And the fencing around, that essentially is 20 plots divided by 20. The whole plot garden divided by 20. So the cost of the materials divided by 20. It's kind of how we spread that cost. You know, we don't have a whole lot of rules associated with the community garden, just except that you wouldn't let your plot go to complete weed. So you don't have to like constantly farm it or maintain it or whatever, but we just don't want a bunch of weeds in there that would be blowing into other people's areas. I did mention that those plots are 12 by 16 feet. Once we get the money to buy materials for 10 of them, we will do that. We will have a community like volunteer build out. We've had some organizations from churches and Boy Scouts that have offered to come out and help us once we start getting to that area. I want to make sure that everyone understands that Aquarius Kids Park Incorporated is a separate entity than the Padre Island Dog Park Association, okay? The Padre Island Dog Park Association, they came to us and said, you know, we've been wanting to do a dog park, we've got some funds to set it up, we haven't been able to do anything because we didn't really have any land, the land we were given. And when I got to talking, you know, to Jan, and when we looked at what the mission of the park was, we thought that that was a good idea to do. We did submit to the city to put in the dog park at Aquarius Park, and to the city parks department anyways, and we were denied that, okay? And so the next effort for Jan's folks and everything would be to then go through the proper channels with the city, whether that's starting with the Parks and Rec Department and then going to ISAC and City Council. You know, you can't get a straight answer kind of what the red tape path is you should do, but that's the next step. Essentially with that. Once they do get approval for a dog park, we, the Aquarius Kids Park Foundation, are happy to work with them in placement of that, okay? So I think it's important that you understand that the dog park has not been approved as of yet. Everything that is over there on that board, as far as Aquarius Park is concerned, has been approved, and we will be moving down that direction. I would love to have all of your help, whether or not you're here in favor of the dog park or not, or whatever. I would love to have your help in making Aquarius Park something that we can be proud of, instead of just a field full of sticker books, which is it currently is, and a playground equipment that was slated for teardown. You know, the city was going to tear it down. And so, you know, I think I just really want to impart to you that the overall mission for us as a foundation is to make that park something that is usable and can be appreciated by everyone in the community, not just little kids at the playground, right? Or me that wants the garden, you know, being something that we can really use. I mean, I would love to be able to see community gatherings there, I'd love for us to be able to have, you know, something there from, you know, food truck perspective and have a little gathering. You know, something that gets people out of their homes and out of their backyards and out and talking to each other. You know, I walked around and handed out, you know, put in mailboxes, you know, it's against the law, I know that, I'm a lawyer. But there was no other way that I could get information out to people because I get a lot of feedback of, I have no idea what's going on. Nobody ever communicates what's happening. So I took it upon myself and walked around with my kid in a stroller to hand out 200 flyers to the houses that I could get to around the park, right? And so, you know, that guys, to me is just really, and what I, so what I was gonna say is when I was doing that, I ran into maybe 10 people over a 3-day period of time outside. And it was gorgeous. You know, this was just over the last couple of days. It was gorgeous. So that kind of, to me, is like why this is another thing that I would love for the park to be. So this is not a necessarily a place that I would like, if you have feedback related to Aquarius Park and what we're doing from what's on the master plan, if there's something that you would like to see there, something you had mentioned, you know, something about a skate park. You know, that's a great idea, right? I mean, it costs a lot of money, you know, from that perspective. But if you are somebody that has a real vision for something that you might like at the park too, please contact us, let us know. I mean, I'm not gonna, you know, I'm happy to help you if we can, but it would be one of those things of let's raise the money and let's see what we can do, right? Because that's where we're at. But so does anybody have any questions for me?
Where does the dog park is not located on your master plan?
No, sir, because it has not been approved. The only thing that is on the board over there is what's currently been approved by the Parks Department. Correct. And so, you know, the dog park is approved. I'm sure they're going to want to know where we intend to place it and things like that.
You know,
exactly.
Where at?
I have a question about the dog park too. The original plan for the one over the ballpark.
Okay, just a second. So, Jan, do you want to just go ahead and get started? So, I'm going to let Jan take over this half of the meeting because I do not have those answers. Does anybody have any questions related to directly to Aquarius Park outside of the dog park?
Do you have, I mean, aside from needing to raise funds, do you have a timeline for things such as the walking paths and the shade structures, or are you just waiting for money to come in?
We are. And then, you know, a huge piece of this, too, is we're still in the process of getting our 501c3 with the federal government, which is our tax exemption, essentially. So once we do that, then we can apply for grants.
Okay.
Right? And so I have not been able to apply for grants yet because I'm still waiting on the federal
government. The dog park's 503C already.
It is. It is. And I've offered them to use that as well.
You know how much fun it is to do that.
Yeah, the problem that we have with that is like when we're writing grants, you know, and looking at places like Texas Parks and Wildlife, to there are some community garden associations, HEB, right, whatever, you know, some of the refineries, and they might not necessarily want to fund the dog park, but they probably would be really happy to fund a playground. So I feel like it's important that we apply for the grant underneath the correct
and there's plenty of them.
Foundation. Exactly, there are. There's a lot of money.
In answer to your question, yes, we were donated a piece of land by the water tower. We had a groundbreaking there. We got some typical opposition as we're getting for trying to bring it back to Aquarius, and I totally understand. The problem with that piece of property is that the excavation alone would be $35,000. And to put in the irrigation. If we put it in the city park, they pay for the water. It cuts our costs down to hardly anything.
But the plans I saw for the one, the original one, was this big fancy thing.
No, that's not happening.
All we need is
no. And so we realize that now. And I understand that there are some people here who do not want a dog park in Aquarius Park. We have not been approved for it. We're asking for less than an acre, probably 3/4 acre. Small dog area, a big dog area, pretty much exactly like the Port Aransas dog park, which is now destroyed. So they don't even have a dog park to go to. We already have the funding, have a security company ready to put in cameras on poles. It will not be open 24 hours a day. It will be open 7-7. It will be a lock system. It's not, I think people have a lot of misconceptions about dog parks. And I've heard a lot of them. I'm willing to listen to any other, you know, people say they bring in crime, which they don't. They smell, which they don't. They're noisy, which they are not. I've been to a lot of dog parks, and they also increase your property values if you do the research. And I have all the research compiled. I'm not ready to present that tonight. I'm going to present it at ISAC. And for those of you who have objections, please come to the ISAC meeting and voice them. And we're welcome to hear them and, you know, work with you on that. It's a very small part of the 10-acre park. We're also willing to work with where we put it in the park, so it affects the least amount of houses. Which are my public speaking, sorry. Yeah, and you think I was in media for 25 years, I'd be a little bit better with this. But anyway, the point is, we have a lot of support. John comes in my office every Wednesday. I'm still driving to Port Aransas to go to the dog park. Where's the damn dog park? And a lot of other dedicated people who, you know, do want it. If it doesn't get passed, it doesn't get passed. But we're going to do everything to try to get it made there, regardless of the objections.
What were the objections last time?
Well, Rhonda, you can address it. I mean, you're probably the biggest objector.
Oh, I'm going to say I'm the biggest objector. So far, there's about 25 people.
I would just like, as a dog lover, I would just like to know what the objections are.
First and foremost, I'm a dog lover too. I have two dogs. Okay. So I don't have any objections to dog parks. Okay. I have objections to dog parks behind people's homes. For example, the Fort A dog park, the Rockport dog park, the Portland dog park, all these dog parks that people are so proud of don't have homes by them. So you can't
have those types of parks on the island.
That's not my fault, because my
I understand that, and what I'm trying to relay is that we don't want it to infringe on anyone's lifestyle or quality of life.
But that's the reason that they don't in the other places. They don't maybe because they're not by people's houses.
Right, but we don't have that option on the island.
Well, then we do not have the water towers.
No, we do not. That's not an option. We have the same opposition there with the neighbors that we have here.
But that's okay over there. It's okay to do it to ours, but not up there.
Respectfully, Mrs. Beadle, it's not up to you, and it's not up to me. It's up to the island residents. And if the majority of them want a dog park on Highway Island, we are going to build one. So the city has already denied it. No, the city has not denied it. They have not approved it. We have adopted it.
So it has been denied by the Adopted Parks Association, part of the city, okay, part of the Parks Department, okay, as our part of our master plan, okay. So when we submitted to them the master plan for Aquarius Park underneath our foundation for adoption, they said you can't do the dog park. We also submitted for splash pad. They're like, you can't do a splash pad, right? I'm like, okay, you know. And they said, these things that we denied, if you want to move forward with them, you have to go through the proper channels, which are ISAC, community, you know, city council, and things like that. Yes, ma'am.
But a couple questions from one statement. When you do put it in a residential area, the people with dogs will continually bark on their other dogs back there. Who will be cleaning up the poop? And you can't tell me that the people bringing their dogs are going to clean it up. I've been at dog parks. There are a lot of irresponsible dog owners. Who's going to be picking that up on a daily basis? Not a weekly, it has to be daily. And how close are you talking to people's homes? Because, like I said, their dogs are going to be barking, and that's a nuisance to them alone. And if they have a big dog, it's going to be a nuisance to the neighbors as well.
I've got a question for some of you.
Let me hear the answer on the maintenance.
So, you know, I'm pretty sure
we have a maintenance fund in place already.
And
there's going to be a membership.
Would that be?
It will be checked daily. There's not, and I have had different experiences with dog parks than you have. I see responsible pet owners taking their dogs to dog parks, and I don't see waste left. But, like I said, we have a monitoring system in place. I live half a block away. My street dead ends into the park. I have a board members who are going to split up in teams, you know, to where we have 24 people that it's kind of like the restroom at, you know, 7-Eleven where you sign off, park checked.
Well, then, and also keep in mind that if you have dogs out there that the owners have not had their dogs
taken
to the veterinarian, and you don't know how you're going to monitor it, whether they
Monitor it with a membership fee. They have to provide their dogs' records, up-to-date shots,
Because species does carry a lot.
And it will be a locked facility. No, we have that covered. And I'm going to present that information at the ISAC meeting. You know, I'm an avid dog lover too. I don't want my dog, you know, around another dog that may have parvo or.
How far away from the homes are you talking?
That's what we want the open discussion to be about. I mean,
that's really an infringement on the people that own the homes right there.
Well,
I've never seen a dog park in a residential area.
Right.
Especially being an island with the hotels that they're planning to put in, as soon as the tourists find out that there's a place that they can take
well,
the dogs.
Well, you know, they subscribe. It's not for tourists, it's for residents.
It's going to be
a locked facility that you have to buy a membership to. The fence is not going to be six.
The
it's going to be higher.
The pool at Compass Bay is a locked facility too, but there's all sorts of people in there that
right.
know the combination.
I've got a question for some of the people here, not all of them, but when you purchased your home there, did you notice that there was a big piece of open ground and there was a sign in front of it that said Aquarius Park? What? When you purchased your home, were you aware there was a park there? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Park was not a dog park. And I own property that is right adjacent to the park with a gate going right out.
Right.
So a dog park there very much concerns me.
No,
I have a little kid also. So my grandson lives with me. And I'm very much concerned about a dog park out there. And I love dogs.
What is your concern?
My concern is that dogs do get away from their owners. And they do run towards little kids, okay? My mother has raised dogs for over 50 years, okay? A lot of different breeds. So you can tell all the different stories, but the bottom line is, there are things you can't control about your dog or anyone else's. So,
okay, so your fear is that
what
yes. someone is going to not have their dog on a leash when they get to the park,
yes.
and
mm-hmm. that can happen anywhere.
It certainly
yeah,
can
happen
in
yeah.
my backyard.
There's people walking dogs off leash every day on the beach,
well,
you know, which is illegal.
You know what?
But,
it may be, but they're not in my subdivision because every day I wave to different people coming down my street and
right.
they have their dogs on a leash.
Right.
And
as
they're
do
responsible
I.
people. And they have a bag in hand and take care of the stuff. And I'm not saying there aren't a lot of dog owners that
right.
are very responsible.
Right.
Because there are. But you know what? It only takes a few. And you got people who come
is
there can't get into the dog parks.
Is it fence?
Yes,
yeah.
there's going to be people that are going to run out of tall locked fence.
How tall is the fence?
The city only allows 6-foot fence.
Okay, well, then 6 feet, but I'm going to have some type of security on the top.
6-foot fence, that's why you don't see
and that would be something from an 8-foot fence perspective. That would be something for us to bring up when we move forward. You know, whether or not that's approved or not. So you have your memories.
Yes.
I appreciate that.
A few things. One, this way is absolutely right. But it has to do with dog training. These people who let their dogs in the backyard and just rah, 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 rah. First thing they need to do is become responsible
yes.
urban dog owners
right.
and teach their dog, train them. You got to train a dog like you do a kid.
I understand.
And train them not to bark. what you were saying, it's going to be monitoring the health records of the pet. What are you going to do? Put a green gate guard out there at the gate?
Respectfully, that's one person at a time. I understand that there's a lot of emotion in this. I get it, right? We really are here to listen to concerns, to tell you the plans as much as we know them right now, right?
We're not trying to sneak a dog park into where it's
called.
No, we're not putting in whether we like it or not. So
yeah. No, I'm saying
it doesn't matter.
You said
it doesn't matter what I think. It matters what the majority of the island residents think. It's a community park.
The majority of island residents don't have homes in it.
Where was this?
I think that.
You said the majority of the audience. Where was this vote?
Well, we're getting to that. We're going to be in front of the ISAC November 6th.
So,
please shut up.
The majority. The ISAC isn't the going to eat that.
So that takes a public comment, and so, guys, that's why we're here, too, right? We're not trying to hire to let you, and we're going in front of the ISAC on November 6th, the meeting's at 5:30 at the Holiday Inn Express on Windward. That is the time for you to come out, whether against or for the park, dog park, and have your voice heard by your constituents.
Let's sit on the ISAC. Let me ask you, on your security system, I get it that you're going to have proof when you first issue. What about when a year later?
It's an annual membership.
Somebody going to follow up?
It's an annual membership, which is monitored by myself and my board. You have to pay an annual membership fee, provide all of that information, and then when your dues are up the next year, you have to provide the same information. Yes, we went over that. You actually can, working with the city to figure out the best way, because the membership fee will actually be a donation. It won't be for profit, so it falls under a different category, because all of the money for the memberships will be put back into the park. No one's making any money off of anything. So since it is a donation-based program,
speaking of donations, are you aware there are several donation cans around the North Padre Island that are stuffed full of money and have been stuffed full of money for over a year? And they don't know, the people in these businesses don't know what to do with it.
I understand that, and I just took over as chairman of the board not too long ago. We've been dealing with a lot this summer. The POA, and I don't want to get into a whole lot of background with this, we'll deal with that at ISAC, but that the whole board has changed over. I've stopped accepting money for the dog park until we get approval, because I don't think it's fair. And the money we've returned to people who have donated, if we are denied, there's no guarantee we're going to get this pushed through. I get it. I didn't know where those boxes were. Sarah was the original president of the dog park. She took a job out of town. And then I came in. So it's been 5-6 years since it actually started, this whole effort. So I'm not completely, you know, Maybeth was the treasurer of the dog park. And so she took care. Well, there you go. No, that's not true. So I didn't even know where the donation boxes were. So I'm just finding all of these things out and trying to catch up. Yes, ma'am.
Who is the board? And how were they developed?
Well, we are now placing a new board now because the original agreement when we had the space by the water tower was if we could raise $50,000, the POA was going to match our $50,000. Well, the POA residents said, oh, heck no, you are not giving any money to a dog park. So they backed out their agreement to match our $50,000. So the POA doesn't have anything to do.
That was never brought up before POA.
Right. Like I said, it was 5-6 years ago when this whole thing started. So the POA has, you know, taken out their funding. Maybeth obviously is not our treasurer anymore. Vicki Wright is our treasurer. She's our accountant for full disclosure. I own half of the Island Moon. So she's our new treasurer, and I do have a new board that I'm seating. But we're reorganizing right now. We're in the infantile stages.
Well, I joined about 3 years ago and went to one meeting, and I was never notified of another meeting.
Right, because there's a lot that's happened in the last 3 years, such as all of Sarah's hard work and doing that, and then she had to leave. I had to pick it up. Then when we found out what a nightmare that lot was that we got donated, and we weren't going to have the money to be able to spend $30,000, $50,000 to excavate it and refill it and fence it, that was a $4 million dog park. We're talking here, maybe $20,000,
$25,000. You're also talking about infringement on residents.
I understand that, and
we
can address that.
That's a horrible thing to do to your residents. They've been living there. You're asking them to put up a horrible dogs.
Dogs don't bark at parks. Dogs don't bark at dog parks.
I was feeling like the fence is right here.
Fences don't stop dogs from barking. Not only do their dogs bark, but people bring in their dogs.
You can't bring a dogs at the park now.
That's a big difference.
Because you have to have them on a leash, and we wanted a place.
Well, that'd be fenced in.
It's all fenced in, big dogs, small dogs. Yes, you can, but you can't because the whole park is 10 acres of stickers. You can't, you can spend the whole time picking stickers.
Okay, I'd like to touch on the barking dogs a bit. Because my dogs, every time a boat comes floating down the canal, they bark at it.
I too.
As soon as it's out of sight, they quit.
Right.
But when you got a 10-acre plot,
no, it's
the nearest,
three quarters of an acre.
I understand, but I'm talking about it's going to be located somewhere on that 10 acres.
Right.
Really, 8 acres.
Okay, so 8 acres. Well, I used to live on 2 acres in Beeville, and my dogs couldn't even see what was going on an acre away. So I don't think it's going to instigate dog barking if they locate it appropriately.
And that's what we're trying to work with everyone.
But see, everybody, nobody, that's not shown anywhere. So, I mean, I'm completely in the dark about what we're trying to do.
I understand that, but there's really no,
let's let this gentleman back here that's been here.
I have a question for you and stuff. So
yeah.
It's about the playground. I appreciate your efforts on improving the children's playground. I
appreciate that.
That's all the parks should be like that. So I really appreciate your efforts. Do you have a price tag on that, what's been approved?
On the replacement? No, because we're going to stay within the playground area that's already there. That's, you know, it's called a safe zone that's already built, so we have to stay within that. When I'm looking at different equipment, and that would be something that I would love feedback from people that donate money to the playground, right? This is like, what kind of equipment would we like to see? I kind of envision it like a mixed age sort of playground, and those costs, like a smaller kind of littler kid, you know, up to like age 8, that would fit in part of that area is around $15,000. And when you're looking at a little bit of a bigger kind of things that bigger kids, like some of the teenagers, some of those spin things, whatever, you're looking at anywhere probably from $5,000 to $10,000, depending on the type of individual piece equipment that you buy. So we're kind of guessing that we're looking probably from $20,000 to $30,000 that we need to raise before we can say we're buying that. And the equipment changes every year, right? So I hate to say we're going to buy this until we have the funds forward. And then I envision that as being kind of a decision of the people that have donated money towards the playground.
And do you have any plans for fundraising, any kind of? Are you going to have a festival? What do you have any plans for fundraising?
Yeah, so we would love to do here this winter, like in January, kind of when it's cooler out. We would love to do what's called like a festival at the park, you know, like a party at the park, and have some of the food trucks come down, which say that they'll donate about 10% of their take, right? There are local musicians come out, play a little music, you know, have something in the evening where, you know, we can get, the city has said that we could get a permit from them to do a barbecue and have like plate barbecue cell type thing. You know, so, and I know there's plenty of people here in Texas that like
also doing great bricks for the walkways.
Yeah, great bricks for the walkways. HEB is phenomenal about donating money towards parks, so is Target. But again, I mean, like, I need to get my 501c3.
Can you do a GoFundMe for the 501c3? GoFundMe?
I'm sure you can. Yeah, but you have to pay money for a GoFundMe, which is kind of crapola. But you know, that's, I mean, it's a good point. You know, I mean, like I'm open to any fundraising ideas that people have. Our big one that we would like to have every year would be that kind of party in the park, or, you know, type thing like that. I'm going to the farmer's market every Thursday, you know, and people get, you know, $5 here, $10 here, it starts to add up, you know. And I kind of feel like, too, once people start seeing things happening there at the park, that they're going to have belief that something's happening, because we've all been in the village quagmire, right, where we've donated money, I've donated money to them, and nothing's happened, right? And that, again, spurred the, I got to do something here, right? So I feel like when the gardens go in, that people are going to be like, oh, dang, you're doing something. With Joe Solis with ABC Painting paints the playground, people are going to be like, you really are trying to do something. You know, so, and when we get a walking path in, my God.
Just all the way
around. You know, I mean, like, what a great, I mean, I jog every day, and I'm jogging on the street, you know, with my kid in a stroller, and it makes me a nervous wreck. I would love to just be able to go around that park.
Yeah.
You know, so.
So that just has a quick question, especially to people who are opposed to the dog park, because we don't, it's not all about that wonderful, what Andrea is doing, and the community gardens,
and giving the playground to them. She has small kids. I just had my first grandkid. Would love to be able to walk down my street and have them there. Would there be, say, that we propose a baseball diamond? Would there be the same opposition for kids hitting the balls and maybe going to somebody's backyard?
Yeah, I would.
So you would?
Yes.
Okay. No, I'm just trying to see what
the noise level of a baseball park is 10 times that.
Exactly.
Of course would be against.
Exactly. So that's the kind of feedback that we need, because we don't, we're not just trying to
So the master plan from 2012 has on there that neighborhood parks are not allowed for dog parks, and this is a neighborhood park.
Right.
So, and the reason that master plan is made that way is for the protection of the people who live around it. So how do we stand on that?
We are you just
that's the purpose of that master plan.
I understand, and we were not aware of that until just recently, so we have requested a copy of the master plan. Dotson knew us, I'm sorry?
We just downloaded.
Yes, we've had that out the first time. Right, I understand.
That was been out of the master plan.
Yes, sir.
In 2015, Mike from the guy that they just watched take the target of all the parks, they went through and they had already approved the Aquarius site.
Right.
So the Aquarius site was already approved on a master plan.
No, it wasn't.
It shut down my set, but the city had given a town
for it. Not in any city official letter.
No, it was not approved.
And what we're looking at all of that, and it may not ever, would you come to your dog or your side if you know it?
Why
should we? It's our home.
I live on my backyard all the time. It's our, it's a city.
We also didn't have to lay a cost for it. The master plan, the city master plan says that for a dog park, they have to have a 50-day park. That way you can put it in the middle and it's far enough away from the houses.
Right.
It's not a downtown day in park. Not only because of the concerns about the dog park, but they don't go. They kind of want to restrict a lot of the development on the smaller parks due to traffic and parking concerns and crime and stuff, because the bigger parks, they can kind of monitor more. The master plan is quite inclusive. It's on their website. You can get it. It's about 40 pages.
Right.
And for a dog park, they want you to have 50 acres. An 8-acre park is for things like the playground, the walking path, gardens. You know, you can probably put tennis courts, that kind of stuff.
Right.
And you know, we're not opposed to developing the park.
Right.
You know, I think the playground would be phenomenal. The walking park would be nice. You know, there's a lot of use for the park. It's just, to me, it's too small for a dog park.
Okay. Well, we have gotten some feedback from the city on that exact issue, and we may not be able to do it, but we just, Andrew's doing this, and God bless her for being going for 2 years to adopt this park and do something with it. You know, the dog park may get turned down and never be there. It, you know, 90% probably will. And that's good news for a lot of y'all. But
we definitely know that, you know, so, and that's the thing is that
we're working with the city.
Master plan. There has been, and I think this is everything city-wise as far as governments are concerned too, is that the master plan is in place, but there is also ways to get around things as far as city council and constituents' agreements. I'm not saying that that's going to happen with this dog park, but I'm saying what we're doing is we're trying to take advantage of the democratic process and move forward and see if we can or not. And if we can't, then we can't. If we can, then we move forward again.
If we can, we'll do it in a way. Yes, ma'am. Because
now you're saying that we can have it,
if
we can't, because you, in the beginning, you said
we are. She means we, the park board.
But now there is a process. As homeowners, we feel like we don't live in the county. If we have the protection of city ordinances, and the master plan is part of that city ordinance, they pay them to get that master plan put in place. Just to get around the things, we're going to deny the rights of the people who are protected by these rules and these ordinances.
And they do a fantastic job.
Two layers of protection there. And they have the right to enjoy their private property, and we all can use taxes in this.
And how other people pay taxes would like to have some sort of improvement.
Right. So, you know, when I say I am in support of helping Jan make this happen with the dog park if we can, right? And that's what I mean by that, you know, but above all else, that is my focus, right? But I'm happy to help lend my voice in support. We're not funding anything to do with the dog park. Her funding is completely her own situation. The maintenance of that is for her to do all of those things, right? And to raise money for that to happen. You know, but there's a big piece of land there that, and I hear what you're saying, you know, and I hear all of your concerns, right? You know, so that is why I think it's so important that you do come out to the ISAC and have your voice heard and make sure that they hear from you, whether you're for or against, because it is not up to me or to Jan or to the foundations to push anything through that the people don't want.
Jan, what about the... at one time, there was talk about across the street in Padre Valley or in the one right off the bridge, whatever they call it now, where the new traffic light is.
Well, Padre Valley is a county land.
Yeah.
So that's not an option.
Well, I mean, second.
Yeah. I think Dale. Well, Dale's coaching football. So, yeah, there's a lot of different rules with the county. Yeah. We have looked at different sites.
Sure. There's there that you can start around.
No, we're not trying to jump through loopholes. We're doing everything by the book. Andrea's an attorney. We're not trying to get around anybody. That's why we invited you all here. We understand the opposition. And like I said, it's not been approved. If there's too much opposition, obviously we're not gonna be there. This will not be an issue.
I think you should really take it hard. The folks who bug up against that.
Because
they don't live up against that park. I'm sure they want, but the people that have run against that park, they should not have this imposed.
Okay.
Yeah. What is the board that you're on?
I'm sorry?
You said you were on the board?
Yes, Padre Island Dog Park.
Oh, the dog park.
Yes. And she's the... So I think we've covered about as much as we can cover. Understand the opposition, and I am going to move forward. So,
have you applied for grant money since you were
yes.
the 502 to fix the park? To fix the park over there where you had it already.
Yes, sir. I've applied.
So you have the money?
Yeah, I have money in the bank. Cross bank. My bank account for the PIDog
park. Is trying to develop the park over there where it is.
Because the location, if you've ever gone and looked at that lot, I had engineers go over there. The development went in there and took all of the fill dirt out. It would cost us $40,000 just to excavate it, not even including the irrigation. Okay, well that may still be an option for us, and we may look at it again. But right now, we're looking at this because it's centrally located and it's a very small part. We're also looking at putting in some parking on the side to the right of the playground. I think she has that marked out. So, you know, it's just an information.
Is there any way it could be put kind of more in the middle? I mean, I don't know.
Right.
But is there a room that's 10 acres or 8 acres or
whatever? Yes, absolutely.
In the middle where it's not going to.
Yes.
We've always wanted to have the walking path. playground.
And she is.
Well, it seems like you're kind of
trying. No, not at all.
I think you would have so much support, and I think we would all really work hard to help you with that effort, because we
all want
that.
Well, then just do that, because we're not joined.
And the same way,
separate.
If you could stick with the tower land that you were given, and really said, this is what we want, and we would, I think a lot of people would really work for you too, even though I don't take my dog to a dog park. I know a lot of people like dog parks, and I would be really ready to go help you with that, but
I
can't support a dog park.
And I totally understand that, but $200,000 for a dog park is just... For that location, it would.
Well,
there's
then,
no
if you think
excavation,
that really
irrigation, fencing, you know.
But you don't have to have irrigation, right, do you?
Yes, you have to have water for the dogs. You have to have irrigation for the grass. Yeah, I mean, you have to excavate the land,
and
then the irrigation, the grass, the fencing.
Well, there's where I would say,
and that's 2.2 acres.
You're going to let us all help you.
Find another alternative location. Talk to the counties.
Trust me, we're looking. We're
I'd be happy to help you work towards that.
Imposing this into a neighborhood.
It's my neighborhood too.
No,
well,
but you're not.
No, I live back five houses off of Aquarius.
But that's different.
That's a little different. Your problem about it is they want to park and go down.
I just want to say that I'd like to be really unfortunate if. People chose not to support what's going on at the Aquarius Park because they opposed the dark dog.
Right,
you know, that would be
right, and I'm she's completely separate.
That
we want
to donate community who are trying to work together.
She
and
will
that is
herself
a positive thing. And so, you know, please don't take away from the positive things they're trying to go on at Aquarius Park because you opposed the dog park. And you have every right to oppose the dog park. I would just really hate to see that somehow the neighborhood, the kids in the neighborhood who my daughter calls it the sad park.
Yeah,
and
it's a sad park.
We really want things that, good things to happen at this park. You know, for that to be a divisive thing would be very, very unfortunate.
So it makes me sad to hear that, and I've heard that. We're not gonna support what you guys are doing at the park because you're in favor of the dog park. Well, let me make it very clear, is that I have two dogs, but they are not dog park dogs. They would not be friendly at the dog park. I will not be a member of Jan's Dog Park Association. I won't be paying her fee. You know, but again, I kind of go back to what's kind of the purpose of the mission.
No one else has stepped up to do anything but Andrea.
Yeah.
It's been a hard road, guys, and there has been a lot of there's been a phenomenal outpouring of support of people, absolutely. But there have also been some very, very negative people about the community gardens, about us doing a walking path, beyond just the dog park, and that to me is incredibly sad, because why wait? You want a park that we can come out to and enjoy. And so, you know, for those of you that bump up against the park, yes, I am in favor of Jan's dog park, absolutely. We are two completely separate entities. Her dog park will not go in Aquarius Park if she does not receive approval. Her upkeep and maintenance of the dog park is separate than what we're doing with Aquarius Park. The reason that she came to us is because she found out that I got approval by the city to adopt it.
And I said, hey, can I possibly, you know, get space here because the city has already put in the irrigation. We wouldn't have to do all that. I understand the opposite.
And I think the thing that irritates me the most about the discussion about
that whole park is irrigated?
No, I didn't say that. Just for the garden.
Just the garden.
There's six
for irrigation in it.
Just the garden.
Right, but you can run a line from that.
They brought water over from the maze. So let me show you. They brought water over from the maze. So let me explain to you. They brought, so here's Aquarius Street. Like, I know this is not your representation, but this is the back part of that park, right? There's a water main right here. They tapped into that water main and brought a line all the way over here and cut over. There's five quick connects that are in place and active right here. This quick connect that was right here that had not been active, they reactivated and tested it. And so there's water at the park. You just have to have one of those things, you know, to spigot, right? And so they have told us too, because we said, okay, well, what if we wanted to try and irrigate some of the grassland here to try and get rid of some of the sticker burrs? They said, no problem. What you would have to do is you would have to get with a plumber, right? You'd have to install whatever, you have to have us come out and inspect it. The city was telling me that. I said, okay, you know, and so if Jan gets to be able to move forward with the equipment in a dog park and she wants to be able to do irrigation, that would be her process. She would have to go with, get a plumber, get it inspected, and things like that. But, you know, we're a long way away. But I think it's a humongous win that we actually have water access at the park. We could actually put in a water fountain.
That would really not get water, because they, that was all.
Yeah, I have no idea. Thank God I'm not involved in that quite
much. It's a private engineering firm, Hansen, that's handling. So they are the ones.
I mean, I got with the city folks and I said, hey, we'd love to put in a community garden. Is that something that we can do? We would need water. What's the process?
Yeah. Back to developing the park, if you put a dog park, I assume it would be in the middle.
And that would be up to how
you can park. There's future possibilities of the soccer field, the ball diamond, the multiple use field.
People don't want that either because it's too
noisy. Not necessarily.
Well, one thing it is going to need, you're going to need shade of some kind.
And you know what? We have approval for two more shade structures right now. We have approval for essentially as much trees as we want to put in that we can water. I don't want to start putting in trees until we kind of start, you know, getting the garden put together where we actually have connections for things like that. And then I wanted to be mindful of where we put trees so that we didn't take away from future use of it. Yes, sir.
Question, where is the responsibility between your foundation and the city? Where is that demarcation line? Once you get the shade structure,
we have to maintain anything that we put in.
Okay.
Except for the water, they maintain those lines.
About the liability part. Some kids out there, they go and break their arm. What happens then?
So it's still city land. Okay. Yeah, it would ultimately be the city's problem. We're a nonprofit, so you know they can try and sue the nonprofit. We have nothing, and we don't plan to probably ever really have anything except for what we have money-wise for, you know, to put structures in. But ultimately, main liability lands on the city because it is their land, and so they have to come out and approve what we're doing. Right, and so if we put in the shade structures, I have to submit the building plans to them, and then they have to come out and approve that it was built correctly. So anything that we want to put in has to go through the city. And so that's why I'm saying what you've seen over there is what currently has been approved. Granted, any structures that are built, you know, they have to come out and
it's
certified.
Who picks up the town on the water bills? Is it the city plan?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yeah, and what the city said too is that, you don't know if you guys are aware, but they open the hydrants and dump water, hundreds of thousands of gallons of water, every other week, every 2 weeks, something like that. And they are thrilled to have the city parks use more water so that maybe they dump less. Which is, you know, my water bill is extravagantly high when I'm trying to garden, so I'm thrilled to be able to have a garden that they're going to pay the water for, you know? I mean, I'm happy to put up my 350. I can buy two freaking plots to get this going. You know, I mean, like, I'm happy for that. Yes, sir.
So, down the Pidogs, 350 is like a permanent one-time cost to build it for you when you own that forever.
It is yours. Yeah. If you move and somebody, so if you move and you give up your rights to your garden, we would pay. We would charge.
It. We would. Like, hey, I'm gonna buy that.
If you wanted to rent to somebody, I mean, there's not anything necessarily preventing you from doing that, but you would be on the paperwork with the foundation, and so if they did, you know, cause a problem or whatever, you know, there are rules that go along with it. You know, we could send you a notice that there's been a problem. You could lose, forfeit your right to your garden. I mean, but, you know, the vision how we see for it is that you pay the one-time $350, that allows us to help buy materials. If you move, right, and that garden became open, the next family that came in would have to pay another $350 because we would like to roll that money into garden number two, you know. Because its use is for, it is for the garden. You know, so, you know, it's a, for me, it's a
great use of the park to have a garden there. I think there's, you know, there's a lot of houses around here that have no yard, really. You know, and so it's easy walking to. You see tons of, I know, I don't know about you guys, if you're out walking around, and there's so many people out and about on a regular basis. So that was why the walking path was important. The gardens and the playground. You know, and shade structure, you know, like we said, we're going to need more shade and things like that. So, you know, those are long-term plans. And, you know, I really think that, you know, once I can get IRS approval on the 501c3, I think we're going to get some good grant money pretty quickly. And I envision that the playground could happen within the next year or so. And then it would be the walking paths. You know, and I haven't even sourced or had people come out and tell me what the cost to do that walking path is, which it scares me. I'm sure it's going to be a lot. Yeah.
They're going to put a walking path in Bloomberg Park in 65,000
dollars. Were they doing cement or crushed granite, or you know?
Cement. One thing I'd like to say, a couple of things. Actually, the nicest place on the island right now is Dowling Park. What's been done over the years is the residents who live around that park, starting like 15 years ago, landscaped it, put in a walkway through the park. The OA supported community vegetable garden. I myself planted a fruit orchard down there. We have a butterfly garden. It draws people in.
That's the boat launch.
When I'm down there, you'll see 10 or 15 people walking through the park.
It's kind of something.
Gardening, kissing in the butterfly garden. It's like a community magnet. Get people out of the house. You'll see people walking dogs. They bring them from, I don't know, pretty far from the island to walk their dogs.
Well, that's where we should have the dog park.
Yeah. Well, you know. Quagmire is going to get drained, at the Roger Allen board meeting last night, they expect to start construction in Dennis Park January 1st. I know from talking to Jennifer Seymour that she has raised, along with the other woman, $45,000 for a playground. And she expects them to start the playground improvements even earlier than January 1st.
She's actually working with her vendor to order the equipment for Village. So it's very exciting. We should at least have one decent one.
Yeah, so it's been quite a while, but I don't think it's going to be a quagmire next year.
Yeah. And no matter how wonderful Village is, the fact of the matter is for me, and I think for most of you that are here, that are around Aquarius Park, that's our park, right? That's where we could walk to. That's where if you've got kids or you've got grandkids or whatever, you know, that's your park. I know that I'm not going to be hauling my kids over to Village that much. It's just, you know, got to get in the car seats and blah, 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 and everything like that. But I can just walk the 3 blocks to Aquarius, and that's why it was important to me, you know, so.
I just wanted to say, I had a couple of things.
Sure.
One thing I was going to say is thank you for stepping up and doing this. I don't live near Aquarius Park, but I do think that it is definitely something that the community as a whole would get behind. One of my questions, I guess because you're still going through all of your 501 through all the
tax exempt.
Exactly. Yeah. So have you really started your fundraising? Serious fundraising stuff, or are you kind of just how are you getting the word out to the community?
Right, so Facebook, Island Moon, Nextdoor, handing out flyers, you know, letting people know, being at the farmer's market, the Joe so nicely paid for the banner that's sitting at Aquarius Park that says, do you want a garden plot, right? So that's where we're at from that. So from a community fundraising perspective, that's kind of where we're at, is small donations, which that's all they ever really anticipated from Island residents, right? I know that our big donation perspective is when we can start writing for the grants. So, yeah, so we're trying, you know, as much as you can without money. And as much as me, myself, can do by myself with, you know, a 4 and a 22 month.
So thank you. And then I just had one question. I'm not familiar on much of the specifics of the dog park. And like I said, I don't live in that area. I'm just a resident on the island. And I can see, I love dogs. A dog park, I would go to a dog park. I would even donate money to the dog park. But hearing all of the different opinions here, I can see how you're going to have opposition because it's so true. I don't live at that park, but I can tell you I wouldn't want the dog park in my backyard per se. So I guess I feel for you because I think it's a great thing that you're doing. And like I said, I could get behind it. I worry about how much money you're going to have to move forward with a good dog park, because I'm like you. I mean, you don't want just a patch with a fence around it with stickers, because that's really defeats the purpose. So I guess my thing is that I approve the dog park. I don't approve it in Aquarius Park as part of the vision of the park. And I can understand why you're going to get opposition. And unfortunately, I think whatever park you go to, you're going to get that opposition.
And we have. But I appreciate that.
Anyway, so that's my opinion, just on listening kind of as an outsider about everything that's going on.
I appreciate that. That's, yeah.
Answer your question.
Yeah.
our best, we are applying for grants.
They never did that to my community.
Okay, that's fine, I understand. And yes, we are applying for grants.
Anybody else have questions?
I really do appreciate everyone coming out and,
about what we're trying to do, and that included the dog park, right? And I got information out. I wanted people to come. And so again, I would appreciate if you, I mean, can trust me and trust that the foundation that we have set up for Aquarius Park, there would be no funding by that towards the dog park. It's completely separate. And so, you know, I would hate to see you not support what we're trying to do at Aquarius just because you're upset about that. So, you know, so I have heard that, and to me, that's incredibly sad. That people are so willing to, and so, you know what, if we move forward, and you go to Isaac, and it's not going to work, then there's not going to be a dog park there. You know, and then hopefully these people, you know, like yourselves,
it's just a shame because it's kind of like human nature when there's a division like that. There's going to be people who are like, I don't believe what they're going to do, so I'm just not going to support it at all. And it's a shame that we can't get our assets and our money, but we don't want it.
Then we'll do it without them. You know, so keep going forward and we'll make it something wonderful. Or an approval or whatever, but we will move forward with what's going to happen in Aquarius Park. We will be getting in a walk-through path, we will have gardens, we will have a good playground equipment, no matter what. And so, again, that's, you know,
there's not a lot going to be happening in Aquarius Park. We'll start literally getting money for that. Not when they know that the dog park's happening. And that, it is a sad situation that those two things. That was somewhere else at this whole meeting that would have been.
It would have been super positive.
It's sad that
it's okay.
Knowing they would do something that would bring everything else.
You know what? I've heard that a lot. And so then I'm not quite sure what the difference was between me getting the able to adoption and what other people's was, except for that I laid on it for 3 years. You know?
Well, we did the same thing.
Yeah, and so we talked about this. I have no idea what the difference was. You know, I didn't get a response for the first year. I got no response. And then the second year, we got to actually put it in the paperwork. And then I didn't hear anything back until the next year when they said, you want to renew it? I mean, so I don't know why they chose ours. I don't. But they did, and I'm excited about working with you there. So.
Swap.
Thank you.